Alright guys, in this video we're going to be repainting the 12 valve Cummins motor. I wanted to do something different other than the original red Cummins signature color. And we're just going to be repainting everything, the P-pump, the lines, oil pan, putting a new trans on. So we're just going to, right now, what's going on is we're just taking off the transmission. We're going to disconnect the fuel lines from the P-pump to the motor, take the P-pump off, the turbo, the exhaust manifold, all that good stuff, and then just get everything repainted. Like I said in the past, guys, this is all previous past film. Some of it got transferred and saved. Some of it got corrupted. So I'm just uploading what I have. There's a lot that I wish that I could upload, but it's not here. So right here, guys, I'm just sanding down the P pump we took off, and I didn't have good footage of that, but it was quite the task to get the P pump off, and I just wanted to get it alone. That way I wanted to make it its own color. It wasn't going to be the same color as the motor. So that's what we're doing right here. Sand it down, threw some thinner on it, and we're about to get it primed and painted. So right here, you guys see me priming the P-pump. The sad part about this P-pump is that I really loved how it came out in the end, but some reason the footage just wasn't downloading. It got corrupted. But I ended up painting it like a blue, like a Ford blue, and I ended up doing splatter technique to it. So it was kind of cool. I did red, white, and blue. It came out pretty sick. This was probably my favorite thing to paint. But sadly, like I said, I didn't get the footage for it. So all I have right here is the priming, but later down the video, you guys will be able to see the blue and the splatter paint job I did, which wasn't perfect, but I personally liked it a lot, so. So I just wanted to point out something real quick on this 12-valve motor. I don't know if you guys can see that orange right there by the oil filter right there, I think it is, or the fuel filter. And that right there, Kyle from Modern Greaser told me that it caught on fire, which was pretty crazy. I forgot how it caught on fire, but it caught on fire, and just thought I'd point that out, just a little fun fact, I guess you could say. So anybody that knows diesels, especially 12 valves, they squirt out a lot of oil. If it's not leaking, it's not working, right? But I just used some degreaser, and I ended up using like a air compressor blow, like the air compressor air, to kind of help me get that oil off. So I did the degreaser, did some thinner, did some sanding to it, really just by hand and trying to just be efficient with it. I should have got a power washer, but I just decided to go this route, you know, so. So again, we get finished up with some of the cleaning. It goes from this to this, and that's with thinning and a little bit of sanding. That's like the where it started on fire right there. It's kind of funny right there too. You can really see it. This is before top shot. This is the after Top Shot really got in the nooks and crannies of the motor. Of course, it's not going to be perfect, but, you know, I wanted to do this 100% the best I could, even though it's rattle can paint job. And right here, we're priming the motor. Already did one coat. I believe we're doing our second coat right here. So this motor has quite a bit of coats of paint, as you guys can see. So, I mean, the more the better, because this motor is going to get really hot. So if it ever peels off, I have multiple layers. So about right here, we're about done with that priming. We shot it in white paint. A lot of people, I posted it on Facebook, and a lot of people were cracking down on me about white. I just wanted to be, you know, a different color motor. Was that a smart choice? I have no idea. But in the end, I ended up changing the color, and I just had like this vision. I wanted to do like this American flag, this American patriot theme to it. But in the end, I changed my mind like 3 times. So, yeah, I mean, it was worth the shot. You know what I mean?
The motor we have right here is white as well. I'm still deciding if I should shoot it again, give it another coat. I believe I did 2, might do a third, kind of run down it. So today I also bought some clear coat right here, some Rust-Oleum. See if you guys can see it. Some Rust-Oleum crystal clear enamel. We're gonna be shooting all over all the parts, so we'll see how that goes. Let's get it.
All right, guys, so I just want to talk about this design right here. A lot of people, a lot of close friends, a lot of people on Facebook chopped me up about the stars on there, but my thing was like, okay, let me do American theme and draw some stars on there that look legit. But in the end, it kind of looked like a kindergarten project. It didn't really come out that good. But I mean, you have this thing in your head, you know, you have this like picture in your head. You think it's going to come out like this, but it really comes out like another way. And that's one of those deals there. So, and right here, my dad did this timing cover, and it came out really good. I really liked it. He kind of messed up at the top left, but I didn't really care because, I mean, it looks pretty sick. All right, guys, right here is where we start to take down the motor for the second time. I didn't like the paint job the first time. I deleted the stars, tried to do the splatter on the motor. I still didn't like the way it came out. We did the turbo and the exhaust manifold gold. That was okay. You know, the P-pump right there looks amazing. That's probably my favorite thing. We did the lines. We did the timing case in the front. We did everything. The oil pans messed up from the crash. We didn't really mess with it yet, but we will. Yeah, guys, that was my idea. That was the theme. That's the NV4500 transmission that I bought, and it was rebuilt brand new. So this is the whole start of the last repaint job that I did, and hopefully make it better. The only thing I wanted to keep was the exhaust manifold, turbo, valve covers, and the P pump, and the timing case cover. So pretty much the block is getting repainted, and the little time lapse of how that went. So we just got some. I didn't feel like taking the P pump off this time, so I kind of just try to spray around it, as well as the valve covers. I plan on going back and fixing those, touching those up, making them look decent. But I just wanted to get it covered in paint really fast, really quick, you know, just get it done so I can move on with the build. So yeah, guys, started off from this nice and oily on fire to this paint job. And it ended off with this. This is what it is. I liked it a lot. You know, I got to fix some stuff where I painted it black, but overall I liked it. I ended up keeping the timing case cover kind of like that. It looks kind of like the Faded Glory, kind of like rough American themed color, which I kind of dig a lot. So that's what I left it in. And we still got a lot more work to do, but overall, I mean, this is just a rattle can paint job. So Thanks for watching.